Alrighty guys, hello and welcome to this quick flight. I was trying to record a previous flight up here from Los Angeles up to San Francisco, but I hilariously messed that flight up on the go-around, which means we'll only be taking it up from San Francisco back down to Los Angeles. Step inside the cockpit, I have the airplane powered up because I just arrived, and we'll be doing a quick turnaround and getting everything here set up. As you can see, we already got electrical power on the airplane. We'll be hooking up ground power here just to unburden the APU. So switch that over here and you can see the temperature on the APU drop because its load has dropped. We're only taking bleed air from the APU. So pre-flight is going to be yaw damper on. This is all checked from the previous flight, so I know the cross-feed valve and everything that is working. Galley is coming on. Everything else over here is looking good. Emergency exit lights are armed. Fasten seat belts signs are coming on. Window heats are already on. Everything over here is looking good. Okay. Let's quickly check the oxygen is okay. So, since we are in a warm, hot turnaround state, I'll go straight to loading of passengers. So go over here to weight and balance. We'll be taking full complement of passengers today. Let me just grab the flight release. We'll be taking 12,507 pounds of fuel. So that means that's what 6,250 per tank. 6,220. Six, two, two, one. 12,000, well, overfill just a little bit. There, 12,650. CG's 29.87. Take up the V cards. We'll be taking a departure on flaps 5. Flaps 5 with an EPR of 1.95. You already have the weather info here, but we'll be grabbing it anew as soon as we'll get the clearance. I'll get everything set up here. I'm using a SITAC panel here for my radio control, so you're not going to see me manipulate these radios down here too much because it's just inconvenient for me. Okay. Clearance delivery is going to be tuned into NAV2, which is on 118.2. It'll be picking up clearance momentarily. I'm on pilot edge, so they should start talking to me right away.
92.9 Papa, go ahead.
There they are. 121.8 is ground, tower is 120.5. And departure today, because we're flying.
Command 229, about contact SoCal approach 134.9.
Because we're flying port 7.
The name's a 7-9er, Mike. Taxi to parking via Delta. If you're going to Millionaire, you can take Bravo. And your pass for the I-3. Good job.
And port 7. 7-9 Mike Bravo to Millionaire. Thanks a lot. Bye.
There we go. I need the points for that. And 135.1 is going to be the departure.
Contact,
I'm going to get that pre-tuned in case I lose that or forget it or something. But we'll be picking up clearance momentarily here. I'm already set to talk on radio 2. So we are set to talk over here to EHF 2. So we'll be talking to her.
John Wayne clearance, picking up our clearance. Quebec request departure.
After that, we'll be doing the departure brief and getting everything in order. Actually, you know, while she's occupied with that other guy, I'm just going to do the pre-flight checklist. So oxygen quantity was tested 100%. Our instrument switches are over here and they're all normal.
Kek 25 off
Yacht Emperor is armed.
Kazakh, is
turned on. Emergency exit lights are armed. Window heat is on. Up here.
3744 green lights.
These four wind panes are heated. Pressurization is going over the ground. And our cruising altitude today is going to be 290. Landing altitude is 100. And our cabin altitude will be set 100 feet below that, which means 0 feet. Instruments heading on the captain's side is 013. Altimeter is 2983, reading 20 feet. 2983, reading just under 20 feet. First officer's side, 2983, just under 20 feet. 013 on the heading. So instruments have been checked. GPS is set to nav. We're not going to be using the Delta Carousel inertial nav system today. We're only be flying it as SLANT Whiskey, which means GPS, I'm sorry, which means VOR DME radials in RVSM space. Parking brake is set. And engine start levers are cut off. Pre-flight checklist is complete. I'll be talking to clearance momentarily. So our departure is going to be...
Bravo, contact Oakland Center 133.7.
So after that guy gives the hands off there. San Francisco Clearance, United 750 IFR to Los Angeles.
United 750, San Francisco Clearance on request.
Okay, so we're queued up behind somebody else.
Scott probably Foxtrot.
We'll be getting runway 1 left for departure, which is 2,200 meters long, 2,800 meters long. Flaps 5 Pepper and four, EPR 1.95 is sufficient for that. I have a pre-computed table for that, which I'll be publishing when it's completely ready. Yeah, the computed accelerated stop distance for our current weight and flap setting would be about 1,900 meters, giving us 300 meters of reserve.
50, contact Oak, Los Angeles Center 133.55.
Initially, we'll be flying. So we're coming out of runway 1, left. Port 7 then demands that we do a turn left to heading 333, so I'll set that up over here in the heading bug. 333.
Air France 50, Los Angeles Center, cross Los Angeles VOR at PNT, flight level 240.
And we'll re-intercept the 350 radio out of San Francisco VOR. So nav 1 is going over to San Francisco, which is 115.8.
Air France 50 negative, cross
and
the
its
Los
distance
Angeles
is zero,
VOR
that's correct.
At flight level 240.
At distance 4 SFO, we'll be turning left heading 203, 1,900 or above. We have to be at that point.
Is close enough, clear through Los Angeles Bravo airspace via the coastal route maintained VFR at 6,500, Los Angeles altimeter 2982.
And our initial climb on the departure is probably going to be flight level 200.
20 left at Kilo Alpha Hotel Charlie Kilo 44 Quebec.
Your 902 X-ray.
Gonna pre-plan my pushback.
King and I 2 X-ray. I'm
got
I'm
my
so
custom
sorry.
Pushback plug in here.
Right now, I was
should also be publishing
some stuff on the GPS.
Yeah, this is how it works. It's basically it gives you a prediction. Which is the primary reason why
no
I wrote it.
No hurry. I just needed you to confirm a correction in your readback on your clearance. You said via Sierra Seal Beach, and it's not via. It's radar vectors Seal Beach. Lynn as file, if you could just read that back for me.
We'll pull forward about 150 meters up close
X-ray.
To the spot. About like that. Yeah, and this is basically where
I'm
we'll
so
end up. And as we're pulling forward, we'll start the engines up so that we don't blast anybody on this gate
time.
Over here.
United 750 service clearance, I'm sorry, I forgot about you. I don't have a flight plan on you though, could you refile?
Affirmative, we'll refile. I filed both flight plans at the same time, so they're probably expired.
Right.
So I'll do the departure brief quickly here, once again. heading 333 out of the runway, intercept 350 radio out of San Francisco, distance 4,900 or above, then left turn to heading 203, re-intercept radio 135 out of Point Reyes, 113.7, then continue up to port.
United 750, I have your clearance now. You ready?
Ready to read back, United 750.
It's 7:50, clear to Los Angeles International Airport, port 7, departure, Avenel transition, Manassas filed. Climb via Civic, set maintain 5,000, expect flight level 290.10 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 35.1, squawk 1336.
Clear to Los Angeles, port 7, Avenel transition, Dennis 5, climb via SIT, SEP maintain 5,000, 2-9er after 10, 135.1, 1336 in the box, United 750.
United 750, repack correct.
Okay, 1336 in the box, 135.1 is checked. Initial altitude is gonna be over here, going down to 5. Climb via SIP, except maintain 5,000, just basically means we need to comply with all altitude restrictions up to 5,000, and then we're supposed to keep it at 5,000. Then, so we'll continue to the departure brief. Radio 135 out of Point Reyes up to distance 40 Point Reyes. Then we'll switch over to inbound heading of 105. Inbound radial 285 out of Woodside. Crossover Woodside radial 116. Continue down to Wages, which is distance 35.15 Woodside. And then we'll continue radial 297 inbound to Avenel. So we'll get the nav radios pre-tuned. I've got nav 1. Let me show you. I've got COM 1 tuned to... That's tower. That's departure. This is clearance. This is ground. So we'll switch over to ground for pushback. We are currently talking to COM 2, so we're currently talking to ground. Nav 1 is going to go over to San Francisco, which is 115.8. Next is going to be after that Point Reyes, which is 113.7. So 113.7. Nav 2 is immediately going to go over to Point Reyes. That will be my cross ref. 113.7. And for the courses here, course 2 out of Point Reyes is going to be 135, so I'm going to just flip that course needle over to 135. That's all set, and so we'll see on the co-pilot side when that starts to come up, we need to turn to 135 to intercept Point Reyes. That's just for cross reference, but we'll be tuned over to Point Reyes immediately before the on the main radio. Okay.
And just for the future, when you check in with a new controller, a new frequency, it's good to.
Fantastic. So we got all that set in. We're ready to start pushback. These gates do not move here at San Francisco in this model. It's still a great model, but those gates are simply not motioning. So we'll be just pushing back by ourselves. Call for push.
Ground to cockpit. Tow is connected and steering pin is inserted.
Okay, I'll do the release, pre-start items here. So,
for 2-2-1,
fire up the hydraulics.
Go ahead.
We should be getting pressure up in the system now. Yep, we do. Left and right fuel tank pumps are on. APU gens are coming on. Ground power is coming off.
Clearance, can you repeat that?
Anti-collision light is coming on. And that's all set in there.
Contact circle approach 134.2.
These guys are coming back in. And before start, checklist to the line. So fuel is checked, 6,200, so 12,400 together. It's a little bit more actually than that, but we're good on the fuel. Passenger signs are on. Windows and doors are closed and locked. Flight director setting One more thing, we need to set the V card. So V131.
Tower wind 22.
So we'll set the flight director over to 148, which will be V2 plus 10. So speed flight director setting is going to be 148. Heading is 333. Altitude initially 5,000 with 1,900 distance for San Francisco. Takeoff speed V1 is 131, V rotate 133, V2 138. PDCS preflight is completed. We're not running the INS here. Trim is going to be set to 3.49, slightly off of that. Units, and we got 0 on the rudder trim, 0 on the aileron trim, and briefings are completed. We'll be taking one more thing on the taxi brief. We got the departure brief out of the way, taxi brief. We'll probably get taxi over on Alpha, Mike 1, down to runway 1 left. Standard reject procedure up to 80, any problems above 80 to V1, only major problems such as engine fire, engine failure, predictive wind shear, or anything that deems the airplane unflyable. I will retard thrust levers to idle, extend speed brakes, apply full braking, and apply thrust levers as available. Above V1, we'll take the problem into the air and we'll continue on the departure. We'll continue straight out. We're over the water.
Was that switched to ground?
We don't have any problem. If we need to ditch, we'll ditch into water. Up to 1,000 feet, we'll take no actions except for gear up on positive rate. Accelerate above
ground direct.
Accelerate up to 210 or clean speed once above 1,000 feet, and we'll assess the situation. On what to do. So that's the departure brief complete and takeoff brief complete as well. Before start checklist through the line is complete, so we'll complete the before start checklist like below the line. Now that we'll start the pushback. Okay, nobody else over here. So parking brake is coming off. It's just going to depress the parking brake. Brake pedals are depressed.
Roger that. So we're southeast ramp, and I have
before start checklist below the line. So I'm going to use head tracking for this. Hydraulic panel is set. Packs are coming off. Anti-collision light is on. Transponder is TARA.
Clear for taxi 221 Alpha Papa.
Before start checklist complete. Dude, you're going to run into us if you continue that rate.
Calling Santa Barbara approach. Say again.
How rude. You just ran into me. What an asshole. Unfortunately, he does not. He just clips straight through. So as soon as we start pulling forward, we'll be starting engines, starting with number 1.
Six Charlie, Santa Barbara approach. Clear from Santa Ynez Airport to Oxnard Airport as filed. Maintain 5,000. Expect 7,000 minutes after departure.
And the reason I wrote this better pushback plugin, as I call it for now, is because it gives you pushback predictions, and it works in a fairly reliable manner. So that means I don't have to watch what's happening all the time like crazy over here. I can just rely on the pushback plugin to do the thing, and I can just focus on engine starts.
Charlie, be back correct. Hold for release.
So we can watch it pushing us back over here, and I can do whatever I want with my rudders right now. It's got overridden control of the steering, so whatever I do with my rudders does not affect it at all. Okay, towing forward. We're past the gate now, so we'll start up number 1. Got sufficient start pressure, fuel pumps are on number 1, start up. Waiting for 20% N2. Nice cool start. Start a cutout. Number 2 start.
Number 2 exit, departure. Radar contact. Skark 5 off at Charlie. You can return
17, 18, 19, 20.
Headed southwest.
Fuel is going in.
It's no preference, just need to know.
Sixteen seconds duty cycle on the starter. So after start items, packs on. APU lead is coming off. Pressurization into ground. Pedo static is coming on. Gens on the bus. I always forget to do something up here, but hopefully I didn't forget this time.
Zero,
flaps
zero.
1, 2, 3.
200.
Weather radar is coming on. TCAS is on. Everything over here looks good. Flight controls check. As you can see, we're still being pulled forward.
Pushback complete. Set parking brake.
And still, as long as I'm engaged in pushback, I can't move the rudder. I'm sorry, I can't move the rudder, but I can't move the nose wheel because the pushback truck is still attached to the steering pin. It's inserted.
1, 2, 5, 6, 5.
Set parking brake.
We'll have a nice flight.
And APU can come off. Before taxi checklist, generators are on, pitot heat is on, anti-ice not required, isolation valve is auto. Pressurization is packs on, auto and flight is set. Engine start switches are, that's the thing that I always forget, low ignition. Recall, no items checked, flaps are 5, green light. Flight controls have been checked and ground equipment is clear, ready for taxi before taxi checklist is complete.
Los Angeles Center. Cross Los Angeles VOR at maintain flight level 240. Air front.
So we can take it up to spot 8 over here. Turn on taxi light. San Francisco ground, United 4, United 780, spot 8, taxi with Oscar.
United 750 San Francisco ground, runway 1 left, taxi via Alpha, Mike 1.
1 left via Alpha, Mike 1, United 780. 750. Okay, I'm just going to grab the latest ATIS because I have the old info here.
So John Wayne Tower, Skyline 221 Alpha Papa, 20 left in Kilo, ready for takeoff.
Altimeter 2978.
Time now
0056 Zulu. Wind calm. Visibility 10. Ceiling 20,000 broken. Temperature 19. Dew point 12. Altimeter 2978.
Papa, traffic. Total
visual approach runway 28 left in
3 o'clock and roughly
okay,
5
we have
approaching 3.5 miles.
We got Papa.
Off the direction altitude 7,800 should be no factor.
Let's see if I can do this departure this time a little bit better than last time. Gonna cut the corner here a little bit. Just to smooth out the
124.7.
Clear left. I'm sorry, clear right and left.
Air France 50 Los Angeles Center, how do you read? Air France 50, contact Los Angeles Center 125.65. Air France 50, contact Los Angeles Center, 125.65, 2565.
Clear left. Alright, so departure review. heading 333
John Wayne Tower,
to intercept 350 out of San Francisco. It's going to come up very quickly.
We'll
continue climbing 1,900 distance 4, and at distance 4 we're going to turn back to heading 203. It's going to be a fairly quick sequence of commands, so need to pay attention to my speed because I have a tendency to overspeed my flaps in this airplane. Clear right, clear left.
Air France 50, Los Angeles Center, cross Bayview at maintain 15,000.
Nothing else has changed in terms of our speeds here.
See, Palmer Altimer,
V1, 131, 133, 138.
John Wayne Tower, 221 Alpha Papa Midfield.
This airplane is super touchy about its flap speeds, even though it wouldn't be in reality. Should be able to fly quite a bit faster than this on flaps, even faster than the placarded speed. But never mind, we'll have to keep to that. At least we can consider it an extra challenge. Okay, Alpha is turning to the right over here.
Shall we?
I know San Francisco pretty well by now, so
I can
taxi here without the signs even then. Even, but just to keep it good, we'll keep to the procedures.
For Quebec, the color approach, polymer altimeter 2981.
Clear left. Taxi light is on, APU is off.
Joey, clearance on request. It will be a full
clear
clearance.
Left.
I'm Sagan for Skyline 82 Golf.
Sorry it's so late, guys. Probably going to be, again, another night flight, which I already have.
Just be prepared.
Plenty of those on the channel. Not super crazy about it. I love X-Plane's night lighting, but
Karen under X-ray, say heading.
Previous flight I did this day, I messed up badly. So there's plenty of flights I do during the year that I record and then don't put up on the channel because they're just no good enough. Not
Kieran
a professional pilot, so I do
I-7.
Make my mistakes.
What was your last
airplane
heading?
Especially when you're flying in a cockpit where you're supposed to be two people cooperating and you're alone for everything.
I'm gonna have to
machine this complicated, especially where you have no FMS.
Start over. What would you like to do?
Okay, before takeoff checklist, we're get the cabin takeoff in 2 minutes. And before takeoff checks, I'm going to do them early so that I can get ready for the lineup. APU is off, radar is weather, TCAS is on, TCAS is over here. Clear left and right.
11:30 to 12 o'clock, or
before takeoff checklist complete.
11:30 to 12 o'clock, and
this is not. Yeah, for one left, we need to continue on a little bit further ahead. Not over here. Not to the left here. We need to continue on for Mike one. This is Mike over here. Mike one is one over. Always catches me out. Get the flight director up into heading mode.
36 Charlie Santa Barbara approach. Ida.
Okay, this is Mike 1 over here. Slow down a little bit through the turn here.
Scott 3's Charlie radar contact 5 miles northwest of Gaviota.
Okay, switch over to the tower. Now we're on tower. She's just been talking to somebody.
Calling services at the request. Come by. Air France 50, contact SoCal approach 119.6.
Yeah, we're gonna have to stop short of runway one left here. San Francisco Tower United, 750 short of one left on mic, one ready for departure.
United 750, San Francisco Tower wind calm, runway one left, cliff takeoff.
One left, cliff takeoff, United 750. Okay, clear left and right. The approach sector is clear as well. Runway one left identified. Lights are coming up. One, two, three, four, five.
Air France 50, have Ocala approach Palmer, altimeter 2981, descend via the Bayview for arrival, except maintain 7,000. Bajav Lindbergh weather and approach request.
Okay, lined up. And stable, 1.95, set takeoff thrust.
John Wayne clearance to Skyline 82 Golf. I'll let you copy
anytime
with the IFR to the Burbank.
Roger. Roger, 4-4, quick expect right down for runway 24. Contact Edward Tower, 118.6, and squawk 25.
John Wayne Tower, 221 Alpha Papa Midfield.
Speed 1
the
and rotation.
Papa, runway 20 left, clear for the option.
Click the option, 20 left, and 1 Alpha Papa.
There we got positive rate, gear up. There's 400 feet. Gonna turn into our heading now.
Skyline 82 Golf, clear to Burbank Airport. On departure flight, heading 220, Red Vector Seal Beach. Then the tech, correction, the
I'm gonna turn on the autopilot here.
SoCal November 1 tech route. Maintain 2000, expect 4000, 20 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 128.1, squawk 7416.
Flaps
coming up to 2.
What I got so far from you is on the takeoff flight of heading of 220 to Seal Beach. I didn't get it. If you give me a Victor way, I didn't get the Victor way, but I said to climb to 2000, expect 4,010 minutes.
Clear 1,900.
Contact departure 128.1 and squawk 7416.
Flaps coming up.
Skyline 82, that was a tech route I gave you after Seal Beach. You'll have to go look it up.
203 is the next heading.
If you can't find it, I'll read it out to you. It's the SoCal.
And there's 4 miles going out over the heading select.
And spelled out, that is, I'm sorry, it's the Coast November 1 tech route. It's Charlie, Sierra, Tango, November 1.
Okay, outboards are off. Runway turnoffs are off.
Just, Charlie Sierra,
and
Tango,
after takeoff
one,
checklist,
after,
engine bleeds are on.
Golf.
Packs are on. Landing gear up and off. Correct. Flaps up. No lights. After takeoff checklist.
Palomar Tower, 3744 Quebec, is about 6 miles
and
northwest.
One is now
Metro
going
Hotel
over to Point Rise.
Archer 3744 Quebec, Palomar
and 135
Tower.
And
135
on
the runway 24. Report midfield.
Right downwind 24. Report midfield 44 Quebec.
Skag 5 off the Fox Shot contact SoCal approach 128.1. And before I let you go, traffic slightly off your. That's about your 8:30, maybe your 9 o'clock.
They have localizer.
Same direction, altitude 3,500, type unknown.
Okay, this went better than I expected. Slightly over the.
QH29 Papa, contact Santa Barbara, approach 120.55.
I got some nice photo textures from a Mr. X06.
No, 750, I'm sorry, contact NorCal Departure.
Over to Departure, United 750. NorCal Departure, United 750, 5000.
United 750, NorCal Departure, radar contact, climb maintain flight level 190.
Up to 190, United 750. Now what? We'll accelerate up to 7.25. Got a little bit of wind shear here.
Okay, I had like three people going in at once. Calling inbound to John Wayne. say again?
One 180.
It's got 2.5 alpha
flaps. There we go. Nav lock.
Terminal 2981. Proceed toward.
So we'll tune this guy over to 135 as well, or take that radial up to 40 miles from Point Rise. Just a little bit too much on the speed.
Kimichi 6229 Papa, Santa Barbara, approach altimeter.
We'll keep the landing lights up until transition altitude. That's policy at United. Normally you turn them off at 10,000 feet.
Air France 50, have fly heading 190. Contact SoCal approach.
Nav lock is now steering the plane.
The airport.
I'll keep the fastened seat belts on for a moment here.
Air France 50, have a correction 090 due east, please.
Temperature total air is plus 15, no problem. Anti-ice shouldn't be required now. Okay, we'll take Point Rise
departure
up to 40 miles.
24 Clinton, wind 270 at 4.
Bring up my departure chart here. Next departure frequency.
One off of Papa, need to report this time runway 20 left clip the option.
Is gonna be, should be Woodside, but I don't remember it by heart. 113.9er. 113.9er Woodside inbound course of 105. And how are we looking? Not quite there yet. And we'll sync up our heading right now and switch it over to heading select for the moment. Are we getting some rain? We're not. Okay. I'll take nav 1 over to Woodside as well.
Altimeter. 2983, it's going to be 5,000. And fly heading 0.
And intercepting inbound 105.
And which approach were you expecting?
Radial 285 inbound to Woodside. It's quite fun having to manage the airplane manually like
it's
this.
It's going to maintain 5,000.
Quite a handful of fly.
What approach were you expecting?
Okay, 11,500. We can accelerate now to 285. That'll be our cruise speed, our cruise indicated.
Air France 50, heavy Reggie. You can expect the visual approach runway 27.
There we are.
Billowing smoke. Like Alpha Henderson gone. Stand by.
These old JTADs. 7 miles to Woodside. Outbound is going to be 116.
Number 3021 Charlie Burbank clearance. Take any request.
And you know, we'll take it like that. Switch it back over to heading select and prepare the outbound course of 116.
Charlie,
as soon as we cross over Woodside, Woodside VOR is coming up just over there somewhere below us. Cleared up to 190.
Charlie, got it at the time. Thank
Should
you.
Be getting
and
our hands off
like
at around transition
altitude and aircraft height.
Track in it.
For 2-9er Pop, Santa Barbara Airport, 12 o'clock and 9 miles reported to say.
13,000 feet. Yeah, we're about 2 nautical miles up from
number
the
number 3, Bravo Romeo, contact
VOR.
Los Angeles Center, 125.65.
Cone of uncertainty. We're on precision. And re-intercepting the radial outbound.
Air France, do you have a heading 090? Number 7,
we'll take Woodside up 35.5 miles, which is wages.
On 5,000. Los Angeles altimeter 2981.
Engines are looking good. We can actually boost them a little bit to 1.8 EPR. I'm trying to get the exhaust temperature to remain in the green. That means the engines are happy. Because they're primarily limited by temperature.
Okay,
there we go. There's Woodside. Re-intercepted.
United 750, contact Oakland Center, 133.7.
33.7, United 750. Oakland Center, United 750, passing 16,300 for 1900.
KVG 6229 up at Santa Barbara Tower, Main Street, and runway 25, clear to land, and wind 260 at 6.
Okay, I'm just playing around here, and I have my altitude selector up on a SITAC panel here as well. I'm
going to
be posting my setup into the comments section explaining how it works. It's a combination of SITAC panels and JoyMap.
Air France 50 heavy for heading 180.
Oakland Center, United 750, passing 17,700 for flight level 190.
United 750, Oakland Center, climb maintain flight level 290.
Climb maintain 290, United 750. Transition altitude. So 2992, we get the altitude alert on the instrument comparator. Hop over
here to the... Standby. Reference 50, I guess you didn't copy. Turn right, heading 180, please.
Kidoke, and landing lights off. And we'll take the cabin signs. Fasten seatbelt off. People can move around now. We're pretty stable by now. We're up to 35.5 miles. We'll take it up to wages. I'm going to pre-tune Avenal into the second radio here. Avenal is 117.1.
You're headed back to John Wayne, correct?
And we're already picking up Avenal over here on the second, the thick line on the RMI.
Stop 2-5 Alpha Charlie, so Kyle Perch.
Check the pressurization over here. Cabin is climbing 3,500 feet, differential 5 PSI.
2-5 Alpha Foxtrot. SoCal Bridge affirmative. I'm not sure what I was calling you, but yes. So are you inbound to John Wayne?
And the outbound course to Avenal is going to be 117, so I'm going to set that over on the standby course.
Sky 5 off of Charlie, expect right down runway 20 right, contact John Wayne Tower.
Yeah, it's going to be a pretty shallow turn. As you can see over here on the co-pilots on the first officer's side, it's
Sky 5 off of Foxtrot.
We're almost on the radial. It's a very slight turn to the left. I'm gonna bump the engines just a touch more as we're getting into colder air.
Charlie, however, gotta bet you got a lot of people in the air. Standby. Reference 50 heavy flight heading 270.
As the air is getting colder, we can't climb to a higher altitude. I'm sorry. We can't set the engines to higher power. Not climb to a higher altitude. We're already climbing.
What off of Papa are you clear the runway now?
Okie doke.
November what off of thank you. Thanks for being off of this frequency and you're past the V1. Good job.
Yeah, the V ratings are for VFR, and the I ratings on Pilot Edge is for IFR. That's a service that Pilot Edge provides you. It's a set of canned tests which you can do, and Pilot Edge controllers will basically grade you on that. And by passing that rating, you've essentially confirmed your skills for yourself. So you are that you're able to fly these sets of procedures. I never really bothered to do any of the VORI ratings because I frankly couldn't be bothered. They don't mean anything in the real world.
Said you're ready for taxi.
So frankly, there we go. 36 miles. We can now switch over to Avenal. So we'll take it over to the.
Skylight 82 Golf, taxi to midfield.
Because it's such a shallow turn, I'm not really too concerned about doing it as early as possible. I'm going to switch over to heading select now. Switch nav 1 radio. Nav 1 course is going to 117.
Reference 50 heavy.
Rejoin back onto the VOR.
12 o'clock, 14 miles, report site.
There we go, 117 is out.
Reference, do you have any?
That was basically just a 1 degree turn.
Final contact, Lindbergh Tower, 118.
There we go, we're 100 miles from Avenal. Tracking inbound. And that's basically our departure. Almost complete. Departure actually goes up to Avenal, and because of the short routes, you can fly up here on Pilot Edge.
Has somebody else had a request again?
When you're flying from SFO to LAX, you're basically going straight from the departure over to the arrival. So there's no on route portion. I'm just going straight to the Avenal VOR on the departure and straight back down from Avenal on the CD6 arrival. I'm just not even. I don't even have to bother with an on route portion. Okay, so heading is synchronized. Everything else is looking good. Engines are pulling. We're hauling ass.
And I'll see you when we get to the top of the descent.
LA Center unit 750 vacating flight level 290. Okay, that's not a mandatory call. She does not have to acknowledge it. Okay, we're 40 miles out of out of Fillmore. It's picking up Fillmore now. 22 miles, so we got 18 miles to Rise. That's exactly what we wanted to. We're about 3 miles ahead. That's exactly right.
Skylane A2 Golf, I did not get a read back on your last instruction. Did you copy?
Alrighty. There's some civilization down there. Some civilization ahead, maybe. Maybe a little bit over there as well.
Skylane 618 Golf, negative. Fly present heading, join the Santa Monica 125 radial.
Yeah, I'm going to pre-tune Santa Monica in my standby over here on NAF2 as well. 110.8.
Check one off of Pop Zone on navigation.
110.8. And we'll put Fillmore over into NAV1. For that, we'll need to do a switchover. So, re-engage heading select here for a moment. Fillmore is in 112.5. We want to be inbound.
107, on San Francisco Tower, when calm, runway 28.
310. Right, clip, takeoff. Well, approximately like that. We'll just take a direct here.
United 750, contact Los Angeles Center, 135.5.
355 United 750.
Calling Burbank Ground. I haven't thought about you. Stand by.
Los Angeles Center United 750 passing 250 for 240.
United 750 Los Angeles Center. Climbing go altimeter 29.83. Cross assignment at maintain 12000. And 280 knots.
29.83 on the altimeter, Simon. 12000, 280 knots, United 750. No, you're not stopping the descent.
Contact 3-6, Charlie contact point, good approach 124.7.
Okay, and we'll continue the descent. So we're now established on the inbound to Fillmore.
Mike Alpha Henderson Tower, did you call already?
It's going to get pretty quick now. So I'll need to react quickly here. So 280 knots at Fillmore.
That's Charlie 280 Park, knots. Hotel Mike Alpha Henderson Tower. Right turn approved.
We've got 19 miles to Fillmore.
We're
continuing our descent now. Passing Fillmore, we'll turn on radio 148.
Skag 2 and Charlie, have you in sight? You said for the option remaining the pattern or departing?
118.8 is going to be Santa Monica, inbound radio 261. So tune
Skag
second
two
radio to 261.
One clear for the option. Correction, clear touch
and
go.
One radio.
And,
it's going to go over to 148 as soon as we cross Fillmore. We're at 280 knots. 21,000 feet, 21,600. Still, oh, there we go, some initial signs of civilization. Got some VFR contacts down there and up there. And something
calling
more up
SR
there.
Calling SR to Burbank's a call sign.
Twelve miles to Fillmore. We need to descend another 9,000. We'll need 27 miles for that. That's a little bit late. So I'll need to give it a little bit of speed break.
Oh, my gecko on a quest, standby. Calling Burbank, clearance with a quest again.
Got a little bit of speed break out. And our altimeter is 2983 that we got assigned, so that's what we'll set in.
Hotel Mike Alpha contact Las Vegas departure.
And the instrument comparator is going nuts again, of course, because we've not set it up over on the FO side. 2983 is now checked. 18,200 now.
Charlie, Flag Out, Hotel Mike Alpha, Las Vegas
cool.
Departure
looking
Radar
good.
Contact.
Landing lights inboards are coming on as per unit policy. And we're coming up on the turn.
Skag 63, 6, Charlie. I think I'm going to miss your call in. Say your request and watch out weather for Oxnard.
Turn now. About 2 miles. And since DME is line of sight.
Skag 6236 Charlie point good approach altimeter 29883. Fly heading 080 vector ILS runway 25 approach. It's gonna maintain 5,000.
Drop another 3,000. We got 10 miles to go.
United 50 contact SoCal approach 124.5.
124.5, United 750. SoCal approach, United 750, passing 14,500 for 12,000 with Mike.
Skag 221 Alpha, Kyle approach, Ontario altimeter 29882. I remain clear of Chino Delta airspace.
Okay, we should be able to make that. We got 7 miles to go to Simon.
One at Alpha Papa.
Drop another 2,000 feet. I always get these loading stutters up over here on San Francisco, LAX. SoCal Approach, United 750, passing 13,300 to 12,000. We have Mike.
At 10,000. And after Santa Monica, heading 070 vector for the airport. Los Angeles altimeter 2981.
Say again, please, for United 750, we got after Santa Monica 070 2981 on the altimeter.
United 750 cross Santa Monica at 7,000.
Santa Monica at maintain 7,000, 070 out of Santa Monica, 81 on the altimeter, United 750. Cool. So we'll continue the descent here.
RTSM 42,
so
number 3.
Cleared all the way down to 7,000 Santa Monica. And we're coming up on there.
Charlie Foxtrot Hotel Mike Alpha, contact Los Angeles Center, 126.35.
So we'll sync up the heading here, re-engage heading hold. Get Santa Monica tuned into Nav 1, which is going to be
11.0. 126.35. 118.0. Skunk 1 Alpha, pop up, proceed direct over Ontario Airport.
And we'll be inbound on a radio of
261. Contact Ontario Tower 120.6.
So inbound radio 261. Alright, 81 is going to be the heading, not that. And rearm nav mode. Coming up on 10,000 feet. So, slow down.
It's a 2-2, Bravo Echo. Burbank clearance.
Nav mode has engaged. Sorry guys for the darkness over here. There's LA. It's the greater metropolitan area of Los Angeles. So we'll head over here and dim the lights. And dim everything over here as well. These can stay fairly bright. I want to turn that down.
507, Mike. My apologies. Contact NorCal Approach 1.
It's got 13 miles to Santa Monica. Passing now down below 10,000. 245. 242. 245 is the restriction there. After Santa Monica, they will... 221
Bravo, go Burbank. Clearance, go ahead.
We'll go to 81 on the altimeters here, as they instructed us. Tons and tons of buildings and road lights and everything lighten up as we get closer. 10 miles. Crossing Santa Monica, I'm going to slow down even further to 210 knots to get all configured for the approach. Need to drop another 1,000 feet, 2,000 feet, we'll make that in the 8 miles. Okay, approach checklist, altimeters are set, 981, 8,500 now. So she already told us that we're going to get the visual 25 left. So I don't need to give her the ATIS info anymore. Crossing Santa Monica.
Step 221 off Hoppa.
Selecting Ontario 070.
When I left down my runway 26 left, going to land when 2205.
1000 to go to 7. You can see it's loading
Charlie
in the city, city light details and tiles, because it's fairly intense on the CPU and GPU and everything to have these this many lights here. There's thousands and thousands of lights. So that's why it's kind of staging the loading process. 2 miles.
01 Bravo Echo, I got your request, stand by. 151 Mike Echo, apology for the delay. You're number 2, stand by.
Okay, speed's going back to 210.
750, contact loss, correction, SoCal approach. 128.5.
28.5, United 750. SoCal approach, United 750, 7000, heading 070 assigned.
Air 158, Sir Whiskey. Yes, sir, you are still on request as well. United 750, SoCal approach. Going to maintain 5000, and you said you're looking for the visual approach, which runway?
Down to 5000 and would prefer runway 25 left, United 750.
At 750, roger, Los Angeles Airport, is it your 3 o'clock now, 4 miles in sight, possibly?
Oh, well, you got the field, United 750.
And at 750, clear visual approach, runway 25 left, and turning final, contact Los Angeles Tower, 120.5.
Clear visual 25 left and turning final to tower, United 750. Okay, pre-tuning tower in the second frequency and 0.75 for ground. Tower.
Make sure to in ROE 21 and report 3 mile final.
So she wanted to basically drop us off as soon as possible, which is why she could throw all the lights on.
0.07 might cut
clear to descend down to 5,000. Actually, we're orbiting clear for the visual 25 left, which means that we're clear to maneuver in any way we like, pretty much, to get to our destination. Which means we'll set it down to 3,000. It's the city center over here, downtown LA.
Bear 1 Bravo Echo, finally your turn. Credit to the advisor to copy, you'll be forward.
And we still got plenty of time for the turn. We'll throw out flaps 1.
0.1507 so flap. Contact Oakland Center 13.
Planning
three
checklist complete.
3.7.
Gonna set my courses here over to 251 for reference.
Charlie Buckshot Hotel Mike Alpha, did you copy direct
just golf? Runway heading here. For go around, we'll be doing a left traffic turn.
We're 150 on Mike Oakland Center, climb and maintain flight level 290.
And we'll tune, actually, you know what? We'll tune Los Angeles
VOR
here. 221
Bravo Echo, Burbank clearance available.
3.6. So do we get a distance readout? Okay, how far are we out? 10 miles approximately. I think it's about time we turn base. So, over the heading.
Air 1 Bravo Echo.
And we'll turn.
Clear
like
to Burbank. Correction, San Bernardino Airport. Elmo 7 departure. Elmo. Victor 186. Paradise direct. Columbia Citix at maintain 4000. Expect 5,000 once we're going to drop
the trim
pressure.
The all pilot is
departure
trimming.
Frequency 134.2, squawk 7041.
There's the field.
Fair 1 Bravo Echo, back correct, and again, thank you for your patience.
Which heading would you like to switch over into? Somebody probably committing an error on doing
Scott
a good job.
Six Harley,
most definitely does do a good job here.
We'll
take it down to 2,200.
160.
Now we'll throw out some more flaps. Down to flaps 5. Yeah, we can take flaps 5 up to 225 knots. That should help us drop the altitude and speed. Take some speed brake as well. And time to turn inbound.
Stack 36 Charlie, 2.5 miles from Kudak, fly heading 230, maintain 4000 to establish local logic, cloud out 025, approach.
Okay, now over to tower. So now we're on tower.
2-3's to intercept.
Gear down. Speed brake is coming to armed.
Skag 2 and Charlie, I have the sight. Roy 2-1, are you full stop, or you said you're the option? What's your intentions?
Mission runway turnoffs are coming on. Yep.
Skag 2-1, Charlie, or Roger. Runway 2-1.
Flaps 15.
Clear for the option, accept full stop. And on departure, fly runway heading and make a right crosswind departure of the shoreline.
Okay, go around altitudes coming in. 2,000 feet. And.
Pepperwood 51, might go drawing in clearance.
Manual flight. My airplane.
Our one Mike Echo. 25. Cleared Burbank Airport for your I-3. On departure, flight heading 220. Radar vector still beach, then as filed. Maintain 2000. Expect 4,010 minutes
flaps
after 30. Departure. Departure frequency 128.1. Squawk 5070.
Landing checklist. Engine start switches are low, ignition speed brake is armed, landing gear is down, 3 greens, flaps 30, green light, cabin is secure, landing checklist complete. Los Angeles Tower, United 750, visual 25 left final.
Contact Oxford 134.95. Two-two-one off of Papa John, request stand by. Pass 750, Los Angeles Tower, you with me?
Affirmative, United 750, you just called you in that we're on the final.
Nice, 750, Los Angeles Tower, wind 260-10, runway 25 left, Clinoland.
25 left, Clinoland, United 750.
Argentina 746 heavy clearance available by Mr. Copy.
Okay. Now we're looking on the Pappy here, just a touch high.
RTA 746 heavy.
I can feel the winds coming from the right.
Parks 2 departure, beach, brings transition and as filed. Climb maintain 10,000.
Slowed down a little bit too early, but never mind that.
Departure frequency 124.85. And Squawk 3302.
Yep, 1,000 below. Now we're 1,000 feet over the field. I can see 2 whites, 2 reds. Let's check that.
That's 3 reds actually. Correct, expect runway 21, and thanks again for your patience. Echo 151, Mike Echo, Drawing Ground 20 left to Kilo, taxi via Alpha Hotel Charlie Kilo.
A little bit low on the speed. There we go. On profile.
Echo 158, set up our clearance. Right, your VFR to Palm Springs with light following.
500.
Checked. Stable. There we go. Two whites, two reds.
130 Whiskey, Cinnabar, Prince. Three Sierra Whiskey, just affirm your VFR to Palm Springs flight following. Right, Sierra Whiskey, confirm your VFR to Palm
Landing.
Springs with flight following.
100.
Right, Sierra Whiskey, thank you. And dawn departure flight heading, catching runway heading, 18 VFR to below 1,500 televised. Departure frequency 120.55, squawk 2334. Alright, Sierra Whiskey, the squawk is 2334. Sorry if I misspoke.
Okay, safely
done.
So we have vacated up here on
2-1 Charlie,
November 8th, Hotel 8. We're not going to make that turn. And we'll be stopping over here. And Los Angeles Tower United, 750 clear of 25 left on Hotel 8. And we're looking for parking on Charlie 7.
It has 750, taxi to Barclay, Mike, Charlie Niner, Charlie, cross runway 25, right, this frequency, good day.
Mike, Charlie Niner, Charlie, Charlie 7, cross 25, right with you, United 750. Okay.
Skark 6,
clean
two,
up
three,
the aircraft.
Six, Charlie, Oxnard Tower, wind, calm, runway 25, put a land.
We got the flaps up, speed brake is up, auto brakes is disabled, weather radar is coming off. And pressurization can now go to ground. Okay. There you go, Mike. It should be over here somewhere. Memory serves right. Oh, it's hardly Mike.
Okay, everybody on the ground, stand by.
Probably going to cross me over here on Papa. Left the strobes on. So these guys can come off, these guys can come off, these guys. I'm going to leave the turnoffs on. Strobes are going to stay on for the runway cross. Runway 25 right is clear.
Number 221, Kirchin. Number 3021, Charlie. Burbank Tower, squawk 2362, ident.
You can see how our strobes are lighting up the surrounding environment. It's very nice. That explains fantastic night lighting. Makes the airplane really stand out. Of course, we got the attached nose wheel light, taxi light. Papa will take it over here. Right on Charlie. That's what she said. What you wanted. So there you have it, guys.
Stand by.
Takes a lot of effort to fly the 737, especially this old type, when you want to do it really by the book. So this is Charlie 9, if I'm not
mistaken. 746 Canyon Ground, runway 21 taxi via Papa Bravo, advise you what.
He's been doing a controller swap.
Just 3021 Charlie, your radar contact, enter right base runway 8.
Charlie 10.
And report to turn to final wind 120
Charlie
at 4.
9. Looking for Charlie 7.
Cessna 3021 Charlie.
Bring up my parking chart.
Cessna 2 and Charlie enter right base runway 8 and report your turn to final wind 120 at 4.
And we'll be parking back in
Barber 158 Sierra Whiskey Santa Barbara Ground runway 25 taxi via Juliet.
This is Charlie 8. Going to be Charlie 7 next. We're parking in gate 73.
Cessna 6236 Charlie.
Yeah, Charlie 7 coming up. That's the guy pulling
Cessna
those
36 Charlie, runway 25, quit land, wind calm.
Clear on the ramp.
Attention all aircraft. When a controller says aircraft on the ground, stand by. That's an indefinite instruction. I'll get to you. Stand by.
I forgot to turn the strobes off.
Our 221 Alpha Papa. John Wayne Clarence, what was your request?
Our 221
Alpha Papa, I'll have it for you momentarily. CFHMA, Los Angeles Center, go ahead. CFHMA, that's attempt pilot discretion, maintain 7,000, contact Los Angeles Center 133.75.
Fantastic mistake.
Our 221 Bravo Echo, did you call
right.
as well?
This is 73 over here. Gates open.
Our 151 Mike Echo, John Wayne Tower, runway 20 left at Kilo, clear for takeoff, wind 2203.
Taxi lights coming off. Overturned a little bit.
CFHMA Los Angeles Center, the Palm Springs altimeter 2984 advise you have 29 palms weather expect visual approach.
Generator on bus.
Runway 158 Sierra Whiskey, Santa Barbara Tower, wind 2605, runway 25, cliff takeoff.
Right. Parking brake is set.
Our 21 Charlie, no need to report, runway 8,
generator on. Number 2. Number 1.
Just 36 Charlie, taxi.
Anti-collision light off. Fasten seatbelt signs off.
Right at that, taxi parking.
Shutdown checklist. Shutdown items actually first, so hydraulics off, pedostatic off, fasten seat belts are off, galley off, fuel pumps, and yaw damper off. Shutdown checklist, parking brakes set, engine start levers cut off, Fuel pumps all off except for left forward. Fasten seat belts off, pedo heat off, hydraulic panels set, strobe lights off, anti-collision lights off, weather radar is off, flaps are up, no lights, and the transponder is going to standby. There we go.
Whiskey contact approach.
Thanks for joining me on this here flight.
Piper 151, Mike Echo, SoCal departure radar
contact. On a very congested day on pilotage. And I'll see you guys next time.